Hi! This video will show you how to authenticate your players in the simplest way, without them needing to log in, create an account, or sign up through a platform. I'm Johannes, and this is Learn with Loot Locker. Guest accounts are the simplest type of authentication that Loot Locker offers. The player can be logged in without needing to do anything, but can still save their progress, upload scores, save files, or even create user-generated content. When using guest accounts, us game developers choose what identifier to use when authenticating our players. We can, for example, use the player's unique phone identifier when they log in, which will make sure all players have a unique identity on our platform and can also return to your game even if they uninstall it. But guest accounts are not super secure. The player does not have a password or email when they log in, so someone could log in as them if they knew their details. Or if the player loses their username, there is no way for you to securely retrieve that account. If you want something more secure, consider also including another type of authentication, such as white label or platform login, all easily implemented with Loot Locker. To follow along in this video, you need to have a Loot Locker account and a game created. You can find a link to do that in the description. Here is a simple setup in Unity that I've made to demonstrate how everything works. The example I'm working on here requires you to be online to start the game, but you can also easily allow the player to play the game without requiring an active session, which I'll show you how to do later in the video. I'll now show you how this example looks and behaves, and then we'll go through the code and implementation on how it actually works. When we start the game, we are presented with a login button. When we press this button, the game makes a request to the server, and the button will spin until we have gotten a response or if there was an error. When we've gotten a response, we can press play, which will take us to a fake game screen, and from here we can go back to the login screen. Simple as that. Right, let's dive into the code. This script is called guestLogin, and it handles the login and takes care of the authentication of the player. At the top, we have a using statement for Loot Locker requests, which is needed for the Loot Locker features to work. We also have a using statement for UnityEngine.ui for the buttons to work. Then we have a enum, which controls the different states that we have in the game. We have menu idle, logging in, error, logged in, and play. And then we have our public enum, which stores the current state of the game. We also have a reference to the animator on the button, and a reference to the button itself. Our start function here is empty, because in this example we click the button to log in, but moving the login function to the start function here would log in the player in the background without them needing to do anything extra. When we click the button in the scene, this button press function will be called. It first checks against the animator if any idle animation is playing, and if there is, it will continue. Otherwise, we return. Depending on what state the game controller has, it will do different actions. When we start the game is in the state menu idle, so we will call the login function. If we are in the error state, we will also call the login function, because we want the user to be able to retry. If we are in the logged in state, we will instead call the play function. And if we are in the play state, we will trigger the button animator, and we will go into the menu idle state. So, let's look at the login function. The login function changes the game state to logging in, plays an animation on the button, then we start the guest login routine, which is what actually logs in the player. First, we define a bool that we call gotResponse, which we use for checking if we got a response from the server or not. Then we make a request to the server to start the guest session. What happens now is that Unity will send a web request to Loot Locker. When sending web requests, you don't get a response instantly. We don't know when we will get the response back from the server. It usually takes less than a second, but that doesn't matter for our code. It will continue, regardless if we got the response or not. This is why we're using a coroutine instead of a regular function. In our case, we want to take action depending on if the user was logged in or not. But if you instead just want to run the function and don't want to take any specific action if it was successful or not, you can use a regular function instead. One thing that can be good to know is that Loot Locker does not have an open connection to the server. When you send a request, you get the response, and then the connection is closed. From Loot Locker's point of view, your game could be running, closed, destroyed, or even cease to exist during that time. So when using Loot Locker, the player does not need to be connected to the internet at all times. It's enough if they are when they make requests. This means that you can, for example, make your game completely offline, except for when they want to upload their score, for example, or use a cloud save system. Alright, enough about servers, let's continue with the code. Here, we wait until we have gotten a response from the server, and then we continue. Depending on what response we got from the server, we play the correct animation on our button. And that's how the guest login works in this example. Now you might be wondering if there is an even simpler way to do this. And yes, there is. If we, for example, didn't care about if the player was logged in or not while starting the game, or if we got an error, you can do this in one line, as in this function. Here, we don't wait for the response, we just tell our game that we are logged in if we get a successful response from the server. Otherwise, we just let the game continue as normal. So by doing this instead, we could later in the game take action on if the player was logged in or not. Or try to make this call a few times until we have a successful connection in the background, without the player noticing. Alright, this was a quick introduction to how guest login works. You can find a link to the full source code of the project in the video description below. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.